दिस इज द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ ह्यूमन ज्योग्राफी. आई हैव मेड वीडियोज ऑन ह्यूमन ज्योग्राफी पार्ट वन, पार्ट टू. पार्ट वन विल बी योर इंक्लूडिंग एग्रीकल्चर एंड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, वेयर यू विल गेट भारतमाला, सागरमाला प्रोजेक्ट्स एंड ऑल. एंड इन द एग्रीकल्चर यू विल फाइंड दैट खरीफ क्रॉप, रबी क्रॉप्स, जैद क्रॉप्स, इट विल बी अकॉर्डिंग टू द इंडियन मानसून. एंड देन इन द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द ह्यूमन ज्योग्राफी वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द पॉपुलेशन थ्योरीज. सो पॉपुलेशन थ्योरीज विल बी लाइक मार्क्सियन थ्योरी, then Malthusian theories and transition theories. So transition theories were like early phase, middle phase, latter phase, and after that now we are moving to the population with the with our updated census data, which was made on 2011. Now in 2021 again this will be made, and as per the time I will make videos on that thing also. So let us see this one. This part 3. So sex ratio is basically where you will measure the population with respect to female and male. What is the number of female, what is the number of male. So if we generally we take it as a 1000 number. So it is like if you have a 900 female in 1000 male, so it will be like the sex ratio will be 900 is to 1000, where your 900 is female and 1000 is your male. So here sex ratio as per the 2011 census, so 940, which is 7 points more than 2001. So if you minus 7 from 240, you will get 233, I guess. Yeah, 233, what I'm saying, 933 you will get. So 933 was in 2001, and after 10 years when we have done the census, so it has been increased to 940. So the number of female has been increased. It means right now we have 940 females per 1000 men. Okay, and in US, Russia, Japan and Brazil, females outnumbers males, that is female is more than male. These are the top four is really, that is US, Russia, Japan and Brazil. So females outnumber the males, so they at those places there will be have number of males will be less and females are more. In some countries you will find that government is forcing to have marriage, like there is a less number of males, so government is forcing female to have like a male to have more than one wife, okay, and forces them to go for a male childbirth because there is a number of female is more in those countries. Okay, so in the neighborhood, if you see our neighborhood by the like with respect to our India, so you will see Myanmar, Sri Lanka and Nepal have more females than males, serially mentioned, like in this order we will find it the number. So Myanmar, Sri Lanka and Nepal have more females than males, and in the world, like if we remove our neighbor part, then you will get US, Russia, Japan and Brazil. And then in the state wise, if you find, then Kerala will have 1084 female, and it means 84 more than male. And in Tamil Nadu you will get 995, then Andhra Pradesh you will get 992. Okay, and if you go for union territories, just remember this content is as per the region when Jammu and Kashmir was not separate. Jammu and Kashmir was a special status state. Okay, so this is Puducherry has 1038, and Lakshadweep will have 946, and Andaman and Nicobar will have 878 number of female than men. And lowest sex ratio if you find, so you will get at Haryana will be have 877, Jammu and Kashmir will have 883, and Sikkim will have 889 sex ratio. And Union Territory is Daman and Diu 618, and Dadra and Nagar Haveli will be have 775. So no need to remember all those things, so just remember like which are the top state, like if you remember Kerala from the lowest one, if you remember Haryana, Jammu and Kashmir and Sikkim and all, so these things you will get. And only three major states, Bihar, Gujarat and Jammu and Kashmir, have declined in sex ratio. And 0 to 6 years, the child ratio will be here. Normally child we have considered till 6 actually 14, but literature or like literate and illiterate we count after the age of 7, I guess. Yeah, we'll 7. We will see in this video. So Kerala child ratio as per the 2001 is 960. Okay, in child sex ratio is also like in the female child and the male child. Okay, normal sex ratio, male and female. In the child sex ratio, how much female have been birthed, how much male boys have been came. Okay, so for 2001 we will find 960, 2011 959, and it has been declined child ratio by 4 points. So it has been declined child ratio by 4 points. So it means 4 points will be your it equal to one number. Okay, so there is some point which gives you that numbering. So here also, if it is 7 point, then there will be have some number for as per 2001. And Chhattisgarh will have 964, highest in union territories like Andaman and Nicobar, Puducherry, and lowest child ratio you will find in Haryana, Punjab, Jammu and Kashmir. And for union territories you will find Delhi, Chandigarh, that is 866 and 867. Okay, so now increased in child ratio in 6 states and 2 union territories. So these are the 6 states and 2 union territories we have find the increase in child ratio. Like increased in what? With the comparison with 2001 census and with comparison to the 2011, that is the recent census. So Punjab will have Punjab get from 798 to 846. Okay, and Haryana 819 to 830. Okay, so it is 11 points. So point is basically same. Yeah, here I think something is missing for the 4 points. Decline by child is a 4 points. I think this number is wrong. So just check it once with the census. And here, so Himachal Pradesh was 896 to 906, Gujarat was 883 to 886, Tamil Nadu 942 to 946, and Mizoram will be your 964 to 971. And union territories, the two Chandigarh and Andaman and Nicobar has improved points from 845 to 867 and 957 to 966 as per the 9 points. 9 points increase there, and in the above, that is Chandigarh will be your 22 points. Okay, so for no sex ratio overall has increased by 7 points, but the child sex ratio has overall decreased by 13 points. And sex ratio 7 and above, that is where the points was more than 7 and above. So it was 2001 that 942 and 2011 was 944, and increased by 2 points. Okay, so for overall country, for overall India, it is telling out. And population density, what is the population density? So population density is a term where a number of people living in per 100 kilometers. That how much, how many peoples are living in, how many people are living in 100 kilometers surrounding. That will be your population density. So for 2011, we will have 382. That is decade growth rate 17.5% and highest in Bihar. So in Bihar, the population density has increased. Okay, that is in 100 kilometer. 1106 people are living in West Bengal, that is 1028. Okay, 1028 people are living in per 100 kilometers, and Kerala it is 860. And in 2001, the highest was in West Bengal. If we talk about the literacy rate, so Kerala will be at the high literacy rate, so 93.91, and then followed by Lakshadweep, and then Mizoram. And lowest literacy rate will be your Bihar, Arunachal Pradesh and Rajasthan. So how we are considering the literacy rate? So literacy rate also depend upon the number of people present in that region. So if the, let us suppose if the region has 10 people and all the 10 can able read and write, so we will get that this place is 100% literate. But if we see the place like Bihar, and where let us suppose the people is 1000, so it is it may be it there is a high probability of chances that not all the people will be literate. So here the percentage will reduce, and so that's why we are seeing for Mizoram and Lakshadweep their population is less, so people are more that are literate. So 92.28 and 91.58. so literate
people, we call it as the people from above 7 who can read and write in any language. Okay. So age structure, if it is the number of people of different age groups, and this is an important indicator of population composition, since a large size of population in the age group of 15 to 59 shows a large working population. So next we will see that pyramid, just hold on, that will explain you much better. So, and a great proportion of the population above 60 years represent an aging population. So see, if we have a population of 15 to 59, it means it is a basically an young age population. Not young age, young age will be found at 30 and all. So India is currently population structure is at around 27-28. So overall, if we found, so we say that India is at a young age population. Okay, and India has a lots of potential, has a huge potential to develop, to become developed, but due to lack of opportunity, lack of literacy rate, lack of facilities, lack of infrastructure in the in the country, we are unable to utilize it. Like if we say Japan is an old age country, so they have people more than 50. If we find the age structure of the Japan, it will more than around 50, more than plus 50 or 60, you will find it. Okay, in the pyramid structure that we will talk about next, you will find that Japan is in the old age structure, but it is more developed than India, and India has a young age structure and it has lots of potential to develop, but due to the lack of all the opportunities, we are unable to do so. So these things are points where government needs to take care. So see, these data kind of explanation might be boring, but just understand the concept. In the part 1 and part 2 videos were completely based upon the concept. Now these videos are based upon the data. Basically it talks about the data based on the census. As we have said, the video is only on the census data. So, and a greater proportion of the population above 60 years represent an aging population, which requires more expenditure on healthcare facilities. Like in the 60 years age population, country usually expend. Okay, earning is less, because at this age people will working people will be less and dependent people will be more. Okay, similarly, high proportion of young age population would mean that the region has a high birth rate and population is youthful, and on the basis of above only, budget used to be prepared. Okay, as per the structure, some countries may prepare their budget on that basis. So what is age sex pyramid? So the age sex structure of a population refers to the number of females and males in different age groups. A population pyramid is used to show the age sex structure of the population. In population pyramid or inverse pyramid represent old age are more and birth fertility are less. So I will describe it. See, if this is your condition, I will show how the graph will look. If this is your condition, if this is your graph, if this represent your above 60 and this is your 0 to 60 age, so see, 0 to 60 age it is declining, and if it is, this is our 0 point, this is our population is increasing in this way. So our old age will be here, young age will be here. This is male, this is female. So our here again, old age is here and young age will be your hair. So it means it is forming inverse pyramid, inverse triangle, and here the country is your old age country. See, this is the figure. This figure we will explain right now. Okay, this is just an overview. Now we are going to the next topic where we will discuss this structure. This structure you will understand. Okay, so the shape of the population pyramid reflects the characteristics of the population. So whatever the shape you are getting in this pyramid, that represent the characteristics of the population. Whether the characteristics will be whether the countries is in increasing, is in developing mode, is in declining mode, or what. is this type of structure is the best structure where the country is in developing mode. This type of structure is where now company has been developed, country has been developed, now it is in declining mode because the most of the people are in old age home. How this will structure will look, we will see in the next slide. Okay, see how this one will look. This side is your men, this is your men, this is your women, and your population start from here. This is zero. Now this is 2 million, 2 million, 4 million, 4 million, 6 million, 6 million. Okay, and this is your age group. Age group is increasing above. Okay, so 0 to 4, 10 to 14, this is 50 to 60. Now let us suppose a country which has population is 60 to 64 more. So more, let us suppose this is 4 million. So this is your one country population. Let us suppose 4 million population is at 60 age group. Okay, then let us suppose 2 million population will have 40 age group. Similarly here it is 40 age group. And let us suppose around 0.5 million will be your at 20 to 24 in both female, male and female. So this structure will be your inverse pyramid. What does it mean? Here in this case, the potential of the country to develop will be very less because the maximum population is in old age group. Maximum population is in old age group. This maximum population is in old age group here, and minimum population is at young age group. So learning will be very less in this kind of a structure, and dependency will be more. So this old age group is more, and this old age group is unable to do work, so they are dependent upon the country. So expenditure will be more. Okay, expenditure will be more. Okay, now see our Indian structure is basically this is Indian structure only. Okay, so our population is major population is in this range. Okay, this is the major population range. And minor is at old age. It means what? Our country India has less dependent people, and this young age population is workable population. This will work for the country. So this population has the potential to grow and to develop the country. See, it is a very important point. That's why I'm giving lots of time in this concept. So what will happen? Like India has this type of population. Here number population is 4 million population is in 10 to 14 age. Like childbirth rate is more, and old age is less. So what this structure will be formed? This structure will be triangular structure, pyramidal structure. So that's why we say pyramidal structure. If a country has a pyramidal structure of the population, so that country will have high potential to grow, to develop. Okay, I think you understand. And even if you will find different graph. Some country will get a graph like this, that no pyramidal, neither inverted nor normal pyramid. You will get this kind of a structure. Okay, like this kind of a structure. So it means what? This country can develop also, cannot also develop, because it has equal number of dependent population and equal number of innovation population. So we can't judge for that country, but this type of a structure, that pyramidal structure, we can judge. But irrespective of this structure of India, we are not rising as per the population structure because of many unskilled rebel. We have the labors which are unskilled population, they are illiterate, lack of opportunity of jobs and infrastructural lack of infrastructural opportunity and all. See, so these are the reasons behind India of not getting utilizing their youth population, irrespective as India is already in this pyramidal structure. And expanding population, what is expanding population? So the age pyramid of Nigeria is a triangular shaped pyramid with a wide base and is typically of less developed countries. This one Nigeria, okay, less developed. Why we have said that less developed country? See, less developed country will have a poor medical facilities. Okay, what will happen? Poor medical facilities, people will die early. So what will happen? The old age population will be less. And what will and another thing, high birth rate will be there. Why high birth rate? Because to make a need labor in their working like for agriculture and all. And what will happen, like due to lack of medical facility, there may be chance there out of 5 children, 2 children will die. So at least they have 3 children, so that's why they will reproduce more. Reproduction process will be more, production of the human being will be more by the human beings. So they will develop more. So like if any single child will be more, they have left another, they have another child with them. That's why their population will be more, like high birth population and death rate will be high and birth rate will be also high. Okay, and the birth rate is greater than death rate in this case. That's why, see, birth rate is greater than death rate, greater than death, and the typically triangular shaped. See, it is not always right, like we can say that death rate is will be more. Death rate will also may be less and birth rate will be greater. That is the same thing it says, like the birth rate is greater than the death rate. Normal concept is there, nothing to explain this much. Typical triangle shaped in developing and least developed countries, usually triangle shaped pyramid observed, like our country is developing one. So recently America has put India into developed one to restrict some opportunities is given to the developing countries, some in trading and all. Some tax was levied for the developing countries. Now America is putting into a developed country list for India, but it is not true. India is not a developed country, it is a developing country. Still it is a developing country. Okay, so these have large population in lower age and group due to high birth rate. If you construct the pyramids of Bangladesh and Mexico, it will look the same. And constant population, Australia's age pyramid is bell-shaped pyramid. So you will surely get you will get bell, different shapes you will form. So bell-shaped will be like this one. Okay, it will something like hazy kind of things. It is not actually bell. It is, see, this is not actually triangle, but an overall structure we are taking it. So, and this shows birth and death are almost equal, leading to near the near constant population, as I have said. And triangular shape is expanding and bell shaped is constant. Okay, where the death rate is also constant and birth rate is also constant. Okay, and declining population in Japan, pyramid has a narrow base and tapered and top showing low birth and death top showing low birth. So the population growth is developed countries is usually zero or negative. The population growth in developed countries is usually zero or negative. Okay, that's it from human geography concept. You can go through all those part, first part, second part, third part. Third part was basically lots of data was there, and first part, second part have more things to explain. Conceptual part was there. In this was also conceptual part. This was very important, this population pyramid theory. Okay, just understand the concept, no need to remember what is the structure of Japan, what is the structure of Australia and India. Just understand the basic concept that India has normally a pyramid structure. Japan, sometimes Japan will have a more old age population in some like in 2020, if this again updated data will come, then we will have a different age group structure. Okay. थैंक यू।